Hi there guys, so we're back here with Maya again talking about the structure of my company and the trusts for the 50 by 4 challenge. So we've spoken about putting all the properties into companies, we've spoken about putting the shares of the companies into trust, that being a family trust versus a company trust. Now we're going to talk specifically about my case. So I've asked Maya to advise me in terms of what the best structure is for my 50 by 4 challenge. So Maya, now let's go to me. I'm going to buy 50 properties. I'm not necessarily gonna buy it all in the same company because there are going to be different investors that will come on board. They are going to invest in different companies, but my trust will own a share in each of those companies. Those companies will buy different properties, but ultimately there'll be different companies and my trust will own shares in those companies. What is the best way to structure all of that?
Well, number one, we looked at various 50 possible properties, not possible, different properties.
Yeah.
So that's number one.
Yeah.
And then you are going to have different shareholders in different companies. So in each company, each investor or shareholder can decide their own ownership structure. Most likely they would also like to put that in trusts. So in your own case, you will have, let's say, 50 companies. Let's split it up like that.
And let's say I have 25% share in each company.
You got 25. So for me, your trust would be a ownership, a holding entity.
Yeah.
So you'll set up a trust, which can be a discretionary trust or a family trust, because it comes down to the same. I would recommend that yourself will be the donor of a trust, and that you can decide then yourself as trustee plus another person, and then maybe a wife or a child, and then a professional trustee. And we already discussed the reason for a professional trustee, and that is to stay completely an arm's length away from your personal estate. And never say that all this decision was made by the head of the family and Nigel overruled and bamboozled his wife and his children to sign here and sign there. That's the role of the independent trustee, to be that third party, to make sure that decisions are made according completely separate from Nigel's personal estate.
Okay, so there has to be three trustees, but only one needs to be independent.
You can have more than one independent trustee. You can be the only trustee with two independents. The whole idea of a trust is also that, remember, you want to be flexible. You don't want to have trustees that sit in different places of the world where it's difficult to contact them. Mm-hmm. If you want to open a bank account, you want to pick up the trustee and say, let's go to Absa Bank, whatever bank, and let's go and sign the application documents. So if you have a trustee that sits in a different place in the world or a different city, then it's complicated to get that trustee to sign bank application documents. So make life easy. I would recommend two family members and also an independent trustee. Looking at the family members, it's actually quite nice. For example, how old are your kids now?
Okay, so Joshua is 21, Karen's 24.
Yeah, so your kids
are just turned 25.
So you know, I've met your daughter and I know that she's also involved in your business. So it's quite nice to actually start involving your children also in your business. So you can maybe make one of your children also a trustee in your trust.
Yeah.
What I also recommend is that when you draft your will, is to look, that's the only thing that you can actually do in your will related to your trust. You can nominate a trustee to take over your position as trustee the day that you die. So it's important to look at that succession plan for your trust as well.
Sure.
In that case, so I would recommend in your case a very simplistic trust, yourself as donor, three trustees. Others, three trustees, two will be family members and one will be an independent person, definitely not a family member, to act as that third party trustees. If you look at the beneficiaries, it will be yourself, your wife and your two children, and then you'll add and their descendants, because this is a trust that will most likely continue after your and your children's death, and then it will continue to during that time and grow a big portfolio over time.
Okay, excellent. Okay, I think that's enough information for me and the way that we are then going to structure my trust. We've already registered two companies. My son has already shown very keen interest to get involved directly. So he will most likely then be the other trustee. And I have a number of people that I'm quite keen to bring on board. Obviously, I would like to bring an attorney and an accountant onto the
Board
of Trustees. So we will most likely then have four people on my Board of Trustees, two independent, being the accountant and the lawyer, and two being direct beneficiaries as well. That's the other thing. Can I, as a trustee and a donor, also be a beneficiary of this trust?
Yes. Okay. Again, just remember that if a distribution of benefits is being made, that you can't be controlling the shots and say, I'm getting all the money in this case. So that's why it's so nice in your case, if you have two independent trustees and two family members, then the decision making can always be shown as above board and taken by an independent board of trustees and not it was a decision.
Yeah, just me.
Interesting enough, just to add to that, in America, if you have a trust, you cannot be you cannot be a trustee and also a beneficiary. So then you have always to appoint an outside board of trustees. And then the founder sits outside, almost like on the side, and he can write a letter to the trustees and say, please, trustees, can you give some benefit to A or B or whatever? So, and if you look at that way of managing your trust, if you use the same concept, then they can never be seen, nobody can ever say that you as the trustee control all the shots, and therefore the trust can be seen as your alter ego. So always apply that methodology when you distribute or make decisions, buy or sell a property in a trust.
Excellent. Okay, guys, so I know exactly what I'm going to be doing now in terms of structuring my company and my trust. I know who I want to bring into the loop in terms of trustees, who my beneficiaries are going to be. I obviously am the donor. So I know exactly how I'm going to structure mine, and I would suggest you have a similar conversation, preferably with Maya, obviously. We'll give you all his contact details at the end of this discussion, so that if you do want to use his services, you can also come and have a conversation with him for your own structure. So we're going to take another break now, and then we'll have one final conversation just to wrap it all up. So stay tuned again, and to this 50 by 4 challenge on our YouTube channel.